of any part of the country. Nobody could have said Kashmir should get independence or some other part should be free. Nobody could have spoken about it. And if you say anything of the kind, that would be an offense. So when Justice Ajit Singh Bains only said, one day we'll be free from this, what he meant was free from oppression, free from injustice. What happened to him? He was arrested, handcuffed. A judge of the High Court handcuffed, paraded in the street and taken before the High Court. The High Court judges could not give bail. That was the law. Went to Supreme Court could not give bail. So he had to remain inside for nearly more than a year. What happened at the end of it? There was no case. This is the kind of thing that was the law. Under Tada law, over 75,000 persons were arrested. They were all kept inside. No bail was given to them. And under the Tada law, the police could extract confessions, torture, variety of ways of torture, violence in torture, all sorts of things, and then extract confessions. And ultimately, what happened at the end of, when the Tada came to an end, sometime in 1995, you'll find, at the end of it, large number of houses, people suffered, all sorts of injustice. But at the end of it, 72,000 and odd persons were just released. No trial, no case, nothing of the kind. But they suffered injustice for months together, years together, inside the jail. And again, what is the conviction rate? Again, one conviction under Tada law was only 1.8%. So yet the Tada law had its effect. It made the police autocrats. The police could do whatever they liked, and none could do anything. The politicians could use Tada law for whatever they wanted, and they could arrest and keep any person behind the bar, and nothing could have been done. So in 1995, the law lapsed because there was widespread protest against this law. We all protested. Tada is a draconian law, and we don't want that kind of law. And it has not brought any terrorism down, if you think of terrorism as such. So this came to an end from 1995. Then, of course, came 9/11, 2001. And what we did immediately, nothing happened in India. Whatever happened, happened in New York, World Trade Center. Yet, Bush had announced, and immediately, he said, there will be war against terrorists. And Bush had again said, those who are not with us are against us. And we wanted to show, oh, we are with America. We are with Bush. So what we did, we brought quota. Again, what happened in quota? It's a versatile law. And hold all law. You can arrest anyone under quota. Again, the same thing happened, what happened under Tada law. And large number of people suffered. And whether and they were arrested, terrorists or no terrorists, nobody knows what it was. This is the kind of law. Law was brought only to terrorize the people. See, this is relevant because today people do talk of quota. They want a law like quota after what happened on 7/11 in the trains in Bombay or what happened in Malagao 2 days ago. They say without law, harsh law, we cannot control terrorism. And I can tell you, harsh law had never been able to control terrorism anywhere in this country or anywhere in the world. Again, when quota was there, as I tell you, quota was being debated in the parliament. And what happened was, when the ordinance was being debated, there was an attack in parliament on 13th of December 2001. Thereafter, when the quota was passed in Calcutta, there was US Information Center was bombed. There came Akshardham Temple, sometime in 24 September 2002. Then came Raghunath Mandir, 24th November 2002. Then we had in Ghatkopar, Mumbai, Mulund, on 2nd of December. And then, of course, Gate of India, Zaveri Bazaar, 25th of August, 2003. So in spite of the law, the water bomb blasts were continuing. And quota had no effect on whatsoever. In the year 2002, according to a statement made by the Attorney General of India at that time, 4,038 terrorist-related violent incidents took place in Jammu and Kashmir, in spite of the army and other security personnel and the law. The number of terrorists killed on the spot in the year 2002 was 1,707, of which 508 were said to be foreigners. In Kashmir, the total number of people killed during the last about 17 years amounts to about 80,000. Thousands have simply disappeared. And this has happened in Punjab. Punjab also, when Khalistan was movement was there, large number of people were disappeared. Nobody knows what happened to them. Till the other day, some years ago, they found the dead bodies, the skeletons on the side of the river Bias. I remember I'd gone there to conduct an inquiry. And what I noticed there was, I went around, talked to people, I went around, went to some houses. And most of the houses, the elderly couple were there, and the younger children were there. The in-between generation was not there. Nobody knows what happened to them. They were taken to the police station in the midnight, and next day they would not come back. And after 8 days or 10 days, they would be found dead somewhere here or there. This is a kind of law. So, question is, violence is a continuous thing, killing and counter-killing. In Kashmir, in Manipur, I went to Manipur, again the same thing. In Chhattisgarh, in Telangana, in many places, killing has been routine. The other day, the Prime Minister suggested we should have counter-terrorist wardens. What does it mean, counter-terrorist wardens? Who should be counter-terrorist wardens? You and I? We take the role of counter-terrorist wardens. I don't know. The Prime Minister suggested that. What happened in Kashmir? We made an experiment some years ago. We had arrested a large number of Kashmiris. They were all rotting in the jail. They were confined to the jail. And what we did was, our government said, brainwash them. Told them, you go back. And go back and tell the people they should not fight like this. They should be afraid. They should change their attitude towards India. Do that. But they said, if you go, we will be attacked. So the government, what the government did, we'll give them guns. So the people who went back were given guns. And I remember during one of those elections, our people's PUDR, the Democratic Rights Organization, brought a report. And there was voting at that time, which said gunpoint, voting at with gunpoint. There was an army gunpoint from the militants. There was a gunpoint from the security force. There was a gunpoint from the other security officials. And there was a gunpoint at these by these people. Would that solve a problem? Violence against violence. Again, what we did in Chhattisgarh the other day. Chhattisgarh, there are Maoists are there, Naxalites are there. How to eliminate them? So we have started a brigade of tribals. Over 5,000 tribals were asked to join. And then they called it Salwa Junoom. And with the result, what happened was, only the tribals were killed, but the Naxalites are still there. This is the kind of thing that we are thinking. So what I'm trying to say is, not a single terrorist in this country has been tried or convicted. Nothing is of the kind. What we have done is only killing. In Bombay, for example, bomb blast took place in 93. Conviction, of course, still we don't know. The conviction, the real culprit, where are the real culprits, one doesn't know. Of course, people who have been rotting in jail for 13 years and so on. Tomorrow is supposed to be the D-Day, the judgment day. I don't know whether the judgment will come or not. This is the kind of thing. And again, you'll find in Akshardham, there was an attack. Again, who are the culprits? They were shot dead. In a parliament attack, who are the culprits? We don't know. We shot them dead. This is the kind of thing that we are doing. So we have only violence as in answer to violence. That is all this kind of thing. Even after 9/11, what did Bush do? He declared a war. War against whom? War against terrorists. War against Osama bin Laden. What did he do? He bombarded Afghanistan. He killed a large number of poor people. No one is sure whether Osama bin Laden was killed or not, but a large number of innocent people died. So also in Iraq, they said, okay, Taliban are in Iraq. They also said, Iraq has got what you call weapons of mass destruction. No evidence of that.